Hello everyone, Treecks here and welcome back to Kirby Super Star. I want to leave this place because I don't like it. I'm not allowed to go to the left. But no, let's get serious now. We are in the Great Cave Offensive and therefore we are in a great cave. A place that is littered with treasures, ready for Kirby to be found. It is by far the longest game so far we have seen in Kirby Super Star, but I think it's also the most interesting one gameplay wise. So let's get started exploring this place. If we press X, we can see our progress. 60 empty spots. 60 treasures to find. I hope I remember where all of them are. But luckily they are positioned in order, so if you forget one, you can see that immediately and go back while you still have the chance. So, 60 treasure chests to find. And let's go see what is all hidden in this place, because that's also one of the more fun things about this place. This down here we can't access, as you can see. More on this later. Because as you can see, we clearly can't access it now. But like I was trying to say, one of the more interesting things about this game mode is the things you find here. Because they're not just random treasures. There's actually a couple of pretty fun items here. The first one being a gold medal worth 10,000 G. So, we're already rich. 10,000 gold. Simple gold medal. Starts off simple, but like I said, there are a couple of pretty interesting treasures here to find. A lot of cameos also. Let's give us beam. And move on with beam, because I'm pretty sure we actually need it too. Okay, in this pillar, as you can see, there's actually a door hidden. And hidden door usually means hidden treasure. I didn't want to go out. Oh, even the pillar respawns. Game thinks it's funny. Okay, don't press up while jumping because you'll go into the door. There's a little bit of a current here, so be careful. Just access the chest from the right and we'll get a gold coin. Which is only 1000 G's. From gold medal to gold coin. Treasures are already getting less worthful. Okay, a couple of bomb blocks as we can see. The second one we don't want to hit because that will actually spawn some lava blocks. Cutting us off from the treasure chest. So don't hit this second one. So we actually have access to the treasure chest here. Giving us treasure number 3. A whip. It's a pretty expensive whip if it's worth 6800 G. Hey, don't! Don't you eat me. But yeah, now I'm safe to crack it. As you can see, if you crack this bomb block, it will give you lava tiles and you cannot access the treasure chest anymore. Not the end of the world, because if you simply leave the room and respawn everything, you can still grab it. Why would you want to do that? Grabbing it the first time through is way better. And I actually wanted that wing ability, because you need it in this room. Because this room actually requires some pretty quick flying. As you can see, we've got a couple of switches opening up some doors here. But they won't stay open for long. And therefore, some quick speed is required. And wing actually gives us that. So, whenever you're dealing with this section, with the doors that close quickly, make sure you pick up wing. And even with wing, you can sometimes be too late, as you can see. Be quick. You can't get locked in here, because as you can see, there are some doors here. If you are not in time, you can use the doors to exit that place. But if you're successful, you will get the crystal ball. So you can actually look into the future and see where all of the other treasures are. If it only worked like that. I'm afraid not. We have to find them on our own. The next one is actually over here. Can still break them. With some copy abilities, it can be hard to attack upwards, but with wing we can still do that. And we find a lucky cat. Only worth 500 G's. Yeah, it's a Japanese game, so lucky cats are very common. I think you can find it in every corner of every street, a lucky cat in Japan. But therefore, Hell Laboratory did not feel this thing is worth too much. Okay, this one is tricky because we actually see a block over here. We don't want to destroy it because the treasure chest will fall into the lava if we do. So make sure we save on that block over there. So, the moment we reach the trigger for the chest to fall, which is this little pillar over here, it does not fall in the lava, because otherwise, once again, you need to leave the room and respawn everything in order to try again. And speaking of trying again, I still need to try again. Because even if you manage to let the chest land on that block, the block can still break, of course, if you try to go for the chest. So make sure the moment you land on the block, you actually have the up button pressed, so it does not break before you open the chest. Okay, hold up to get the Seiryu sword. Once again, this game is Japanese, so excuse me. But okay. Tricky little treasure chest. But it was a very valuable treasure. The most valuable treasures are the ones that are hardest to get, logically. Here we actually find a screwball. Samus, I think you've lost something. It is present in this game. I don't think you need it in Metroid Prime yet, but in Metroid Fusion you do need it, so make sure to pick it up again. Okay, we can break this little block over here to get in this little niche over here. Nothing to the left, but to the right. I believe there's a hidden door. Oh, never mind, it's a chest. I don't want to go to the door. But anyway, now that we're in here, this door is actually a safe point. And even a rest section, because it gives you a maximum tomato as well. But in the Great Cave Offensive, you actually find safe rooms every once in a while. Even the game realizes this game is a little bit longer, and usually therefore can't be completed in one go. I of course will do it in one go, but the game does realize that it can be a little bit longer and gives you the option to stop by giving you the save point every once in a while. The Ichigo candy, once again, this game is very Japanese, so a lot of Japanese stuff is going to be present here as well, but luckily not all of them. Also, a couple of pretty fun little cameos, like Samus' screwball, that you find as the previous treasure. With that present there, you can expect more game cameos to show up. That's a spoiler alert I can quickly give you. Okay, with all the stuff on the left destroyed, on the right destroyed, we can return to the left and get ourselves our treasure. Because of us being underwater here, most of the stuff we can't destroy from underwater. So we had to do it from the land. Once you've done that, we can access this area. And therefore this chest, giving us a zebra mask. 278,000 G's. It's interesting. Well, what the hell? Kamikaze Bronto Bird. That guy really came out of nowhere. There you are. Still hit me. Hi. Okay, give me that ability. The boomerang Poppy Bros gives you cutter, actually. Not all Poppy Bros give you bomb ability. The ones carrying boomerangs will actually give you cutter. Okay, we got a bunkers boss here, which you can destroy easily by breaking the blocks below him. Or he can just kill himself. Yeah, cutter is not really an ability where you can easily break blocks below you, so didn't really work out. What the hell was that? Kamikaze enemies are a thing in this game. Okay, plasma whips, but no treasure, so not interested. There are some treasures in some of these niches here, but... Nope. That was the wrong way. I want to go up. Because here is a treasure. And that is... a star stone. Well, Kirby's an expert on using stars. Warp stars and stars that you can use as projectiles that some enemies give you. The star blocks, of course. He lives on Pop Star, which is a giant star. Kirby's an expert on stars, so he knows how to use the star stone. In all these years, there's never been a star ability, though. We do have star rot and everything, but... Oh, didn't expect them to do that. Come on. Oh, ability's gone. Oh. Get in there. Stupid one space openings. A beast's fang. Interesting. Reminds me of the big fang from F-Zero. One of the machines there. Biorex's machine. Number 15, the big fang. Kamikaze kaboo. why are all the enemies in this game kamikaze enemies? Okay, I would like to keep Cutter because I know there's a treasure chest coming up where we need a Cutter ability. Sword, Cutter or Ninja, so I want to keep this one with me for now. Yeah, like I was talking about, there are a couple of things coming up, like these wires here, that you can only cut with a Cutter ability. Cutter, Sword or Ninja. So if you have one of those three, you can actually cut these strings here. And access certain locations you otherwise can't access. So in this room, make sure you keep Cutter with you. Or find Sword somewhere, because Ninja I'm pretty sure you cannot get quite yet at this point in the game, so... Oh, be careful, there are also a couple of tag enemies here, so they can steal your Cutter. Or if you use an ability too close to the edge of the screen, you can also die. Okay, I still have my treasure, so don't worry about that. The game saves you at a certain location, but it does not save the treasures. All of the treasures you've kept until you died are actually still there. It only saves your location where you were. So the moment you die, you do still have all of your treasures. Okay, let's do this correctly this time. Okay. Kind of forgotten that Abyss was so close to Don't You Dare. Stealing my abilities while falling. Bandana, okay. It's red bandana, so it's not Bandana Waddle Dee. Come on! Tech enemies falling from the sky. That's something I'm not agreeing with. Okay, I still have my Cutter. So this is the whole reason why you need it, because of this little niche you cannot access otherwise, but this one actually has a treasure chest, unlike the previous ones. Go away. Don't even want to know what that is. And this one gives you springtime. It is depicted as a pink heart for some reason. But springtime is actually the final treasure you get in the first section of the Great Cave Offensive. Because even this game is cut up into... Hey! Give that back. Never mind, he's already lost into space. Like I was trying to say, even the Great Cave Offensive is cut up into multiple sections. Four to be precise. And we haven't seen Jet at all. A little bit in Gourmet Race, but not a whole lot. So let's use that for the boss. And at the moment you actually reach the final part of a section, you will get a boss for that section, which in this case is Fatty Whale. Pretty weird boss, which is really hard to defeat with Jet, but I'll try. He has multiple moves, like you may expect. And the moment he shows himself, he's on screen, we can actually hit him with any ability we have. This one is definitely the most annoying move, where it starts raining rocks. Can be tricky to avoid. Oh. Splash! You actually got thrown upward. Also really fun. Bam! Yeah, the jet ability is most of all a charge ability, as you can see. You charge your jet, and you can fire certain moves. If you just fire normally, you will simply get shot to the different side of the screen. And if you use it when near an enemy, you can actually launch that enemy for damage, stuff like that. That's the basic use of Jet. And it also gives you a little bit of a different flying ability. But anyway, we find the trolley here. And the trolley will actually bring us to the second section of the Great Cave Offensive. The jungle part is done. Let's move on to the next one. Which, in all honesty, is my least favorite section of the Great Cave Offensive. But it does look the nicest one. This one has the nicest aesthetic. The most beautiful background and the best music. This little crystal cave section is annoying to get through and get trying to get all of the treasures. I think they are really well hidden here. And even the route is pretty tricky to find the best route to take through here, because it can be confusing which rooms give you continuations and which rooms are just treasure rooms. Can get confusing here, but here we find a dime, which is actually worth 10 G's. Which is interesting, because this dime actually tells us how much a G is worth. 1 gold in the Kirby universe is apparently only 1 cent. Because if a dime is worth 10 G's, and we know a dime is 10 cents, so we know 1 gold is 1 cent. It looks interesting, a G, but it's actually not worth a whole lot. But here we have a save room. Every new section actually gives you a save screen immediately, so... sounds only logical, right? Okay, and this is the part I meant. I'm not too sure which one is continuation and which one are just rooms with treasures, but we'll find out. The moment I find continuation, I'll double back immediately. And that bump enemy killed himself. Okay, here we have a switch. Oh yeah, that brings down the waterfall. So we can actually swim through this room. We find a goblet, which is worth $8. Because 800 G's we now know is $8. Okay, let's move on. Let's get Bomb. Don't kill him. That's the whole reason why I don't like helpers. They do things I don't want. They're computer controlled, and therefore not controlled by me. So they do things I don't want them to do. Okay, here we find the switch. Be careful with this switch, because it'll spawn a treasure chest, which will fall into the abyss here, if you're not quick enough. And guess what? I wasn't quick enough. Let's try that again. Any challenge you fail, you can immediately reset by resetting the room. Let's try that again. Make sure you are in a position where you can go to the right quickly the moment you hit this. Because this saucepan, which is worth only 10 cents, can fall into the abyss here otherwise. The time of easy treasures is over. We actually need to work for our treasures now. Okay, let's get ourselves Crash, because Crash is awesome. And we also need it, because there's a door here and the switch is on the other side. And only with a screen nook we can reach it. It does not only kill enemies, even switches get activated with a screen nook, as you can see. And we find ourselves a brass knuckle worth $200. It's a pretty expensive brass knuckle. Okay, another switch forming a waterfall. This one we can use going upwards. Let's return to Bomb. And this one's easily gotten. Can't really miss this one. Amber Rose. I don't really agree on the fact that it's worth so much. Amber is a gem, after all. And gems usually are pretty valuable. Oh, there's wind here. And I lost my bomb. So we need to work against the wind here. Ooh, two treasures even. First one being a fish fossil. Fish fossil. Well, we are on the ground here, after all, so we can find some fossils. And the other one is a beast fossil. The treasures kind of belong together, you might say. Probably the reason why the game gives us two at once. Let's get out of here. This time the wind's a little bit easier, because it's going our direction. Let's finish up this room. Because I'm pretty sure we're making full circle now. Oh, there's even a mini-boss here. Puppy Bros Senior. Bomb versus Bomb. But we don't really have to get this ability because we've already got Bomb. We get some nunchucks here. More weapons. We already found brass knuckles here and now we find some nunchucks. A weapon-heavy room here. And it's even a Japanese weapon. Once again, Japanese game. A lot of Japanese treasures here. So, where were we? Oh, I'm actually missing one. What the hell? After the dime. The dime was in the main room. So let's return to the main room, because I've got every treasure in this room. Oh, I think I know. These blocks, the chest the dime was on, are actually breakable. I forgot to look down here. There's actually another treasure down here. Glass slippers. Sorry, Cinderella. I completely forgot about you. Yeah, that was the 15th treasure. Yeah, like I said, some of these treasures can be pretty well hidden, especially from this second stage and onwards. But we're still on schedule. Treasure number 23 coming up next. Let's return to where we were. Don't forget to look at your treasure progress every once in a while in case you miss one. Like I said at the beginning of this, luckily they are depicted in order, so you immediately see it if you miss one. But with this we've reached 20 minutes and luckily we're at the save point, so very good position to stop for now. Next time we'll continue in the Crystal Caves. See you folks next time. Treecks out.